Hi guys, battery you can see, it's removed from a Prius high voltage electric vehicle. The hands you can see belong to a highly trained technician. This shouldn't be done at home. Jewellery off, protective gloves on. Protective gloves go up to 1000 voltage. I'm also stood on a rubber mat this side of the wooden worktop bench. Vehicles come in to the workshop here with a trouble code for P3000 battery abnormality, which we've received the printout from. You have to excuse any background noise because this is a professional workshop, plenty of work going on in the background. Here we're going to test the battery itself. Now the battery itself, through one end to the other, has a reading of zero. Now why is that? I've got a breaker plug removed from this end. This splits one half of the battery from the other, making a 300 volt battery, 150 volts on each side, and a lot safer to work on. I'm a hybrid trained technician and I'm allowed to perform this task. Individually, each module is made from 6 cells. And here we have a reading, just over 8 volts. I'm testing this as it's connected in series still. Each can be read at just over 8 volts. If I was to test 2 at a time, clearly I'll get a reading just over 16 volts. To identify this battery fault, I've tested all 38 of these cells on this hybrid vehicle. Here you can see I've got 8 volts again. If I move across to the next cell, 6 volts. To me that says I've got a bad cell along that module. And eventually I'm going to remove this module and fit what we have here, a new module. You'll already be able to identify a repaired module as all the numbers are in sequence. All the serial numbers go up one at a time as you go through. That's the order of the barcode it was produced in. Clearly our new one here has a very different number on it. Connected in series at 8 volts gives you your total voltage of over 300 volts. A lot of your systems work at just under 300 volts and a lot are a lot over, so this should not be tried by an untrained professional. This is not something to try at home. The circuit breaker here should have been removed before removing the battery from the motor vehicle. To remove this cell, we'll undo the bolts on the bottom and simply slide it out. The electrical connectors on the back here can be seen slightly aged, and they'll be cleaned up with just some vinegar and some Coca-Cola on the end of a toothbrush. Obviously we'll grease them before refitting it. Your module at the end of the battery here will not be faulty if you're showing up a trouble code on the dashboard. If it says battery problem, that means this module is working okay and you do actually have a problem with the battery. The system is very simple and also very dangerous. You should not try this at home. Thanks for listening.